that God will make the day in which to honor your faith in the name of Jesus. You know, the Bible says that 1,000 years with our God is like but a day. But we've been told that there are 365 days in a year. If God can handle the project of 1,000 years in a day, I'm sure that the projects of 365 days can be hard anchored in the moment. And so I'm believing God for you that every blessing that should have gotten to your hands since the beginning of the year that have refused to come, before this day is over, the Lord will deliver it to you in the name of Jesus. For the man that will say a loud amen, God will deliver it to you in the name of Jesus. Something strange happened as I was walking back into the church. I started hearing voices, different voices saying the same thing. And all I heard was, it's time to go, it's time to go, it's time to go. And I was asking, what is time to go? And God opened my eyes. The first thing I saw a treasure base filled with money. And I saw the money opening their mouth and they say, it's time to go. Now listen, listen. And God said to me, he said, this week is shifting money from where they have been locked up to go into the hands of the people that need them. Wait, 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 wait. Now what that means is this. Unexpected money. I'm not just talking about 1,000, 10,000, 50,000, 100,000. Huge sums of money will shift base and locate somebody here in the name of Jesus. Some of us standing here, by this same time next week, you will give testimonies that tens and hundreds of millions of naira got into your hands in the name of Jesus. Now, I'm not just saying this to excite us. I'm standing on the altar of the Lord. If only you can connect with your faith. I'm telling you the truth. Between now and the next Wednesday that we'll gather here, there are some of us here that the kind of money we'll handle, we have never handled it before in our lives. It's not going to answer to your efforts. It's not going to answer to your strength. It's just going to answer to the grace of God. And that grace will work for you in the name of Jesus. You can trust me. I quickly told God the number of millions that I want. I don't want to bother my head how God will do it. I know that God will give it to me. I don't know about you. I said God will give it to me. Now the second thing I saw a pool of cars. Brand new cars. And I saw them opening their mouths and they say it's time to go. Now there are some of us here, you have been believing God for mobility or change of mobility before the end of the year. Get ready, because before this week is over, cars will be driven to your doorstep. In the name of Jesus. Well, I know some of us said amen because other people are shouting amen. But as the Lord God of heavens lives, next week, Wednesday, before the message, we will call for people to come and testify. I only pray for you that you will be amongst the testifiers. In the name of Jesus. All right. Now, we have with us this afternoon, all the way from the Pentecost Assembly in San Diego, in Chile, Pastor Andy Jaja. Let's put our hands together as we welcome him. Don't worry, towards the end of the service, he will still come up. He will greet us in Spanish. You know, some of us, it will be like tongues to us. Hallelujah. The Lord is using him mightily over there in Chile. He was here with us. He was at the Pentecost Assembly at Prince and Princess Estate. And from there, the Lord moved him and his family to Chile. And let me also say this at the end of the message, be a blessing to him. We were together yesterday, and then he was just telling us about the challenges there. I'm telling you, at a point I said, is it a sin to be in the mission field? You know. But despite all odds, the Lord is opening new doors for them. Just barely 2 years he left here, God has helped him. He started one, he has moved to another place, despite all the challenges. So please be a blessing to him. In any way you can, be a blessing to him. And the Lord will bless you too in Jesus' name. You don't know, maybe your child or your grandchild will find himself in Chile one day. And the seed you are sending there will be the bail that will set to that child's destiny. You don't know. I know people here that have been having challenges with their children, and all we needed to do was to call the pastor over there and say, please, we have one of our children there, help attend to him. If we have not been helping them, and you call and say, pastor, please, I have somebody there, help them. We say, help. You better come from Nigeria and come and help. So you don't know what you are doing. It might not just be for you. It might be for the seed coming out of you. Please be a blessing to him. And the Lord will bless you as you do that in Jesus' name. How many of us will be traveling before next week Wednesday? You want to travel? Don't let me say I pity you. You don't ever want to miss out of the last breakthrough hour for the year. Should I give you a piece of advice? Reschedule your travel. Don't travel until after that breakthrough hour. Please. I know some of us, the moment we go, we are not coming back until the first week or the second week. You are going to miss the covenant week. You are also going to miss the last seed of the breakthrough hour for the year. Please don't. You can travel on the 28th after the breakthrough service. And the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Can we please close our eyes and just appreciate the Lord again? Let's appreciate him again. Let's thank him. Let's thank him for who he is. Let's thank him for who he has been to us. Indeed, it's never late for our God. He is God. He is God. He is God. He is God. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. Afternoon. that is carrying a load of care, and you are saying to the Lord, Lord, when will it be that you will take this load of care away from me? I have good news for you, that the time for that load of care to be taken off you is now, in the name of Jesus. So you will pray to him and say, Father, I can't hear you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I will never go from here until that Lord is taking off my shoulder. In the name of Jesus, take the load of care away from my shoulders. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray to him. Take this load of care, this burden, take it away from me. In the name of Jesus. Somebody open your mouth and pray. Jacob said to the angel, I will not let you go unless you bless me. Somebody hold on to God's legs. Hold on to him. Say to him, Jesus, 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 I will not let you go until you are attended to me. I have come to you today. Help me. I have come to you today. Come through for me. In the name of Jesus. Somebody open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Oh, what peace will often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains will bear. All because we will not pray. All because we will not tell it to the Lord. Come on, somebody tell it to him this afternoon. Somebody tell it to the Lord this afternoon. Tell it to him. Tell it to him. He is able. Tell it to him. He is mighty. Tell it to him. He is able. Tell it to him. He can do it for you. Now, 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 now. In the name of Jesus, tell it to the Lord, tell it to the Lord, tell it to the Lord, tell it to him. We will pray today until something happens. We will call upon him until he answers. Pray to him, pray to him, pray to him, pray to him. You have carried that burden for too long. You have gone about with that problem for too long. Won't you want God to take that problem away today? Pray to him like you have never done before. Pray to him like you have never done before. 9 days to the end of the year. That problem must not go into the new year with you. That challenge must not go into the new year with you. Open your mouth and pray to him. Open your mouth and pray to him. Open your mouth and pray to him. If only you will pray, God will answer. If only you will cry to him, God will hear your pleas. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. I can't hear your amen. I say, in Jesus' name we are prayed. And I stand on this altar as God's servant to decree that every burden that I has been on your shoulders since the beginning of this year. As surely as the Lord God of heaven lives, before you leave his presence today, that body will be taken of you. I said that body will be taken of you. In the name of Jesus. Jacob said to the angel, I will not let you go until you bless me. And the angel did not go until he blessed him. There are angels sent by God to this assembly today. I want to pray for you that that angel that God has sent specifically for you to attend to your need, that angel will not leave this place until he has attended to your case. In the name of Jesus. I want to pray that prayer again. Because I know that for every one of us here, there is at least a ministering angel that God has sent to attend to you. I decree, according to the order of Jacob, that that angel that has been sent by God to you will not have a way of exit until he has attended to your case. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
God bless you. May please be seated. We'll be rising up intermittently to pray. We will pray today until something happens. It's never late. Let me tell your neighbor again, it's never late. Maybe that person didn't believe you. Turn to another person and tell the person, it's never late. And I'm serious. It's never late with our God. We're talking about God that created the heavens and the earth in a day. Just one day. Every one of us just opened our eyes and then all we could see in the book of the beginning is, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. Just in a moment of time, God created the heavens and the earth. That God is the one you have come to meet with this afternoon. And I want to pray for you again. Everything that seems like it's getting late to be attended to, before this year is over, you will sing a new song over it in the name of Jesus. The book of John chapter 11, you can read from the beginning to the end, is the story of Mary, Martha, Jesus, Lazarus, and the disciples. It's a story that we all know about. Now destiny is a function of time. Destiny is a function of time. And destiny is the devil's target. And that is why, if the devil knows that he can't get through to your destiny, he brings in delay to work on your time. Because he knows that if he can delay time for too long, then destiny can be frustrated. That's why sometimes we just discover that there seems to be a form of delay all around us. All the devil is aiming at is to bring you into frustration, so that the destiny that God has written concerning you is not fulfilled. But I want to pray for somebody here. Even where you have experienced delay, the Almighty God, the one that created time and season, will compensate for the days, the weeks, the months, and the years that the devil has brought delay into your life, in the name of Jesus. I want to pray for you. It will never be too late for you. In the name of Jesus. In the book of Genesis chapter 19, you will remember that God sent angels to Sodom and Gomorrah to go and destroy the place. And the angels came and then they found Lot. And they said to Lot, we have been sent by God to destroy this land. He said, but because you have found grace in the sight of God, we have God's command to rescue you and anyone that you choose to call along with you out of the land before we destroy the land. And so they said that to him. That was his destiny. His destiny was that he will not be destroyed along with Sodom and Gomorrah. But for some reason, the devil came in with delay tactics. They said to him, just call as many people as you love to call and then hurry out of this place. And the devil made him to begin to drag his feet. What he should have done hurriedly, he was just going about it. And when you get to verse 15, you read verse 15 to 16, the Bible says that when the angels saw that he delayed, they held him by the hand and they said to him, look, you can't be wasted because it is not written in your destiny that you'll be wasted. So they held him by the hand and they hurriedly took him out of that place. Listen to me, I know that there are angels on assignment right now. And the assignment is to rescue you from every form of delay that has been posted by the devil to frustrate your destiny. And as surely as the God of heaven liveth, every one of us that are going through one cycle of delay or the other, the angels of rescue will rescue you in the name of Jesus. You will no longer be a captive to delay in the name of Jesus. Some of us don't understand. You know, there are some of us that it will take us ages to take decisions that should have taken just a day. There are some of us now, vital decisions that we should have taken since the beginning of the year, we are still on it. You will go one step forward, you take three steps backward. Others have taken that decision and they have gone, they've left you behind. But for some reasons, you just find that it's difficult for you to take the decision. Because the devil has come in with his delay tactics. Let's make it impossible for him to take that decision. Let him stay there. I want to stand to pray for you. For the man that will receive it in faith. Every cycle of delay that the devil have orchestrated in your life in an attempt to frustrate your destiny, I decree the angels of God will rescue you out of it. In the name of Jesus. Listen, delay is the devil's strategy. It's the devil's strategy. Progress is God's agenda. It is God's delight that will make progress with our lives. God doesn't delight in the afflictions of his children. He doesn't have delight in it. Rise up to your feet. Let's take this prayer. I've said to you, don't forget that there's an angel standing by you. You may not see him, but there is an angel standing by you. So you're going to lift up your right hand to the Lord and pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, under your authority, I speak to that angel that is standing by me to move on my behalf now and fight every force of delay that have held me down, that have made it difficult for me to fulfill destiny. In the name of Jesus, somebody open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Is that the best you can do? Let that angel fight every force of delay. Every force of delay posted around you, orchestrated by the devil in your life. Let the angel of God rise up on your behalf and fight them, and fight them, and fight them, and fight them. Makasoke poskayita, brangaluke ruposkoyete, benderege rimbaskoyita. Every force of delay, spiritual delay, financial delay, marital delay, academic delay, I come against you in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray, somebody pray, somebody pray. That letter that should have come out, that has not yet come out, it is because there is a force of delay that is working against you. The job that you should have gotten, that you have not yet gotten, it is because there is a force of delay working against you. Open your mouth and pray. That promotion that have refused to come, it is because there is a force of delay working against you. Pray, pray, pray. Check out.
Every force of delay, we come against you, we come against you, we come against you, we come against you, we come against you. That proposal for marriage that should have come long ago and is yet to come is because there is a force of delay working against you. Pray to God. Thank you, Father. We glorify your name. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. And I stand to make a decree that every force of delay that have hindered from coming the commanded blessings of the Lord for you for the year 2011, I crush them in the name of Jesus. In any form they have chosen to operate in your life, every force of delay that has been at work in your life, I terminate it now in the name of Jesus. For the man that will say a good amen, I terminate it in your life in the name of Jesus. That letter that should have been out long before now, that have not yet come out because the forces of delay has been broken, before this time next week, that letter will be in your hand in the name of Jesus. The proposal for marriage that you have been waiting on God for since the beginning of this year that has not come, now that the force of delay has been dealt with, that proposal will come. The appointment you have been believing God for that have tarried all this while because of the forces of delay, now that the forces of delay have been destroyed, between now and the next time we gather, that appointment will have been given to you. The man that is occupying the seat meant for you, that thought that he has gained the victory over you, as surely as the Lord God of heaven lives, between now and the next time we gather here at the breakthrough service, that man will be brought down and you will be enthroned on your side in the name of Jesus. Whatever the forces of delay have kept back from getting to you, by the authority that created the heavens and the earth, I decree 7 days counting from now, that thing will get to you in the name of Jesus. If you believe that God has just done something for you, come on, give him a shout of hallelujah. I can't hear you. Give him a shout. God bless you. You may please be seated. There will be myriads of miracles. Amen. Countless number of testimonies. Amen. This week, starting today, I was praying with the ministers and God just gave me that word. He said it's the breakthrough week that is starting today. Amen. This week that is starting today, counting 7 days from now, the kind of testimonies that will get to you will be beyond your expectation in the name of Jesus. So Jesus was told about the case of Lazarus. They said, Lazarus, your friend, the one you love, is sick. And Jesus said, okay, I know. Some of us may find it difficult to believe, but God knows about your sickness. He knows about the pains you are going through. Jesus said, I know. And the disciples asked him, say, what shall we do? He said, we will go. He said, but this sickness is not unto death. And after a while, the Bible says that he needed to go to Judea. He was sent for to come and attend to Lazarus. But something diverted him. And he was going to Judea. Along the way,
Message got to him that Lazarus was dead. And he said to the disciples, he's not dead. He's sleeping. You know why? Any death, the death of anything that is not permitted by God, is not death but sleep. The devil may think that he has laid it to rest. He has done the final deal on it. And as far as the devil is concerned, this is a settled matter. But as long as it is not ordained by God, there is no death that is called death. It is a sleep. And anybody that is sleeping will surely wake up. I'm standing on this altar to prophesy into your life that every death that the devil have uttered in your life, I don't know the death of worth, because it is not from Jehovah, I convert it to a sleep in the name of Jesus. And because it is a sleep, you are waking up from that sleep today in the name of Jesus. I say you are waking up from it today in the name of Jesus. I have this strong feeling in my spirit that God is waking up several things in our lives today. Things that probably even you have thought is dead. God is waking it up today. Because it is not death. They said to Jesus, they said Lazarus is dead. Probably the disciple will be one is because you delayed. But Jesus said, even if I delayed, it is not death. Because I have said to you, it is not a sickness unto death. So it's just asleep. You have not lost that thing. Somebody didn't hear me. I said you have not lost that thing. You may not be able to find it around you now, but get ready, because that thing is coming back to you. Whatever thing the devil has stolen from you, taken from you, that seems irrecoverable, by the power of the one that created the heavens and the earth, God will bring it back to you in the name of Jesus. And you know what? He will do that before this year is over. I can't hear your amen. I say he will do it before this year is over. In the name of Jesus. So Jesus said to them, we will go and we'll wake him up. Even if people that are working on your case have gone to sleep, because the matter must be settled before this year is over, God will wake them up this morning. Even if they said the man is on leave, he will be recalled from his leave to come and finish the work he has started. In the name of Jesus. If it is that the man left without designating that office to another person to continue the work, they will compel him to give the power to another person to continue on your case. In the name of Jesus. He's not dead. Tell your neighbor he's not dead. One of the things our Father and the Lord used to tell us, the general overseer, if a member of the church dies, and they will call on him and say, Daddy, we have this challenge, please come and pray. Daddy will say, bring out a mantle. He will pray over the mantle and say, go and lay it on the person. Wait for 24 hours. If after 24 hours the person is not awake, then allow the person to go. You know what he's doing? He's placing a demand on heaven and on hell. If it is not a death that is authored by God, it will be converted to sleep. And several people have had that handkerchief placed on them and they came back to life. There were others that they laid the handkerchief on them and they slept on. You know why? Because there is one that God says, this is death. And there's another one that God says, this is sleep. May I pray for you again? That every death, every problem that has been uttered from hell, that is now a problem that you are battling in with your life, as surely as the Lord God of heaven liveth, here on this ground today, it is terminated in your life. In the name of Jesus. Delays. Delays come sometimes because of indecision. Like I've said, many of us were where we are today, not because God is late or God is slack. concerning his promises, but because you can't just make up your mind as to what you want. Many people, they are double-minded. Is it this or that? And the Bible says that a double-minded person is unstable in all his ways, and that man should not ever think that he can receive anything from the Lord. And that's why you will pray to God that every form of unbelief and indecision spirits in you, that God will help you with it. In the book of Songs of Solomon, chapter 5, there is a picture that the Bible paints to us. Somebody was in the house, and his beloved came to the door. And the beloved was knocking at the door. "Open the door for me." And the man, the lady inside, said, "Look, I want to put myself in the right shape." So she was busy wearing perfume, making, using makeups and all that. By the time she now got to the door and she opened the door, she said, "Ah, I opened the door and my beloved was no longer there." There are some people in now, they are crying to God and say, "God, bring my married partner. But when God brought that person to your doorstep, you were busy making up. And now that you have opened the door, the person is gone. Several of us, God have said to us, "This is the business you should do. Go into it. And just let me prepare myself. Now you have finished the preparation, the door is shut. Indecision. I'm praying for you this afternoon that every delay that indecision have caused in your life, by God's mercy, the Lord will end it in your life in the name of Jesus. Many of us, it is the wrong use of our tongues. We have said all manner of things against the working of the word of God in our lives. Mary said, "The handmaid of the Lord, let it be unto me according to your word." But many of us, even when God is giving us an assurance that this is what I will do, we still argue it out with him. And because God says, "My spirit will no longer strive with man," God leaves you. He leaves you. We've said all manner of things. In fact, some of us already, we have ended this year. We have said, "This year is gone, and nothing has happened to me. Let's hope that the year 2012 will be better." And in reality, this year is not gone. We still have 9 days. Nine solid days to the end of the year. But for you, the year is gone. So some people, the year is just starting. Even if it's just one day, some people believe that God can still come through for them. So don't use your mouth to bring yourself into delay, because God can do anything at any time. Let me dwell more on the next point. Sometimes it is that gates have been shut against us. In the book of Joshua, chapter 6, the Bible says, "Now Jericho was straightly shut because of the children of Israel. No one went in and no one came out because of the children of Israel." God gave the land to them, but the enemy shut the gates against them. And many of us, we don't have spiritual discernment to know that some of the delays we're experiencing are as a result of gates that have been shut against us. Somebody will say, "Oh, it's very hard to get a job in Nigeria. You have hundreds of thousands of graduates on the streets. It's just by a stroke of chance that you get a job." For your information, on a daily basis, vacancies are being declared and people are being given employment. On a daily basis. There is no day in Nigeria that people are not employed to work. No day. There's no day. On a daily basis, what you said is not happening in your life. On a daily basis, other people are experiencing it. So something should tell you that if you are not experiencing what others are experiencing, it is that a gate is shut against you. Some of us, we know when you want to travel by air, they normally give weather forecast. If there is stormy wind or there is hazy cloud, they say to you, "The boarding gates are shut. No flight is taking off." It doesn't matter the preparedness of the pilot and the air crew, as long as the weather says no flying, nobody flies. And guess what?
If you have ever been at the departure hall, when flights are delayed, you will see frustration on the face of people. People are frustrated. Why? Because it's like every plan they have made is scattered. Many of us, we are frustrated because the boarding gates to our flights have been shut. Stormy weather. And then you could see that frustration on your face. All you need to do is to declare, let the clouds move. All you need to declare is, God, let the clouds move. And let the flights begin to operate. I want to stand on this altar to make a decree into your life, that wherever gates have been shut against you, wherever the clouds have been made to work contrary in your life, by the authority in the name of Jesus, those gates are declared open in the name of Jesus. Daniel prayed unto God. God answered him, but there was a principality that decided to shut the gates of heaven. The prince of Persia, he shut the gates of heaven because it was a principality that operated in the air. And believe me honestly, there are gates to every place. There are gates. Just like we have doors leading into the church, there are spiritual gates that you can't see with your eyes. There are spiritual gates. So the prince of Persia says, as far as I'm here, the gate through which the angel will pass to get to you, I will close it. And you know what? He was so powerful that he held down an angel for 21 days. For 21 days. God had to send reinforcement for that angel to break through and for the door to open. There are some of us, angels already have been given the answers to our prayers. But because the principalities on the way are too strong, they have held the angels down. But you know what? Reinforcement is on the way today for you in the name of Jesus. For the man that understands what I'm saying, I say reinforcement is on the way for you today. In the name of Jesus. God can open any gate. He can open any gate at any time. He can. There was a man by name Evil Merodach, a wicked man. God moved him on the 27th day of December of that year, when people were already saying the year is over. But a king was in prison, Jehoiakim. And God said, look, even though this gate has been shut for many years, but I want to open this gate. The gate that the man had been believing God for to open since the beginning of years. Just 3 days to the end of that year, God entered into the heart of a wicked king. The one that should have kept him in prison. And God said, listen, I want this gate to open. It doesn't matter how wicked that man may be. He says, your promotion will not come. Not when God says the gate for your promotion should be open. And I want to stand to decree into your life that every man born of a woman, every woman that takes in the breath of God, that says you will not accomplish that which you desire before the end of this year, the gates will be opened against him. In the name of Jesus. So you will rise up and pray and say, Father, I can't hear you say, Father. In the name of Jesus. Every spiritual gate and every physical gate, shut against my fulfillment, shut against my desire. Like the gate of Jericho was broken, break the gate open in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray to God. Open your mouth and pray to God. Open that gate, oh 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 God. Mm-hmm.
Ask God to open the gate. Open the gate. Open the gate. Open the gate. Every cause that I've allowed delay in my life, Father, break it. 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 In the name of Jesus. Break it.
Thank you, Father. Glorify you in Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. I can't hear your amen. I said, in Jesus' name, we are prayed.
That have been shut against the fulfillment of your desire for this year.
Every curse that have allowed for delay in one form or the other in your life, I decree on this altar this morning, let God scatter it in the name of Jesus.
There's someone here, they've told you that you have perforation in one of the organs of your body, internal organ, internal perforation. And the only solution to it is surgery. The Lord said, I should say to you, you are not going through any surgery. As surely as he leaves, he's going to close up that perforation in you.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's one amongst them, you've been bleeding for some time now because of that same problem. That bleeding is going to stop before the end of today. As a sign that God have healed you of that perforation. Now, I'd like those people to just come, just quickly come. Will minister to you very quickly. Now there's someone here. Every time something good is about to happen to you, you have a dream. And in that dream, you see your late father. And the moment you see your late father, it takes you away from that area where something good is about happening to you. And then you wake up. By the time you wake up into life, you discover that the good thing that was coming your way is no longer available. There is a curse in the bloodline of your father. It affected your father, and the same curse in that bloodline is what is affecting you. But God says, because you must sing for joy before the end of this year, he said that curse is going to break over your life. If you are that person, I'd like you to just quickly come also. Quickly come forward. Lift up your hands to the Lord. Lift up your hands to the Lord. I will crave your indulgence. We may take like 10, 15 minutes more of our time today. Let's just bear with us. We don't have all the time till the end of the year. And what must be done before the end of the year must be done. If I have my way, we'll extend next week's breakthrough hours to 2 hours. So that we'll have time to extensively deal with issues. Because the womb of 2011 must not close up on the blessings meant for you. Please help me separate them. Those people with perforation, let them stay separately somewhere. I want to personally minister to them. Now the rest of us, let's lift up our hands to the Lord. Maybe you are here this afternoon, you have not given your life to Jesus. You have not surrendered your life to Jesus.
and you want God to step into your affairs before the end of the year, I'm saying to you, it might be very difficult for God to do that. God looks out for his own. He says that the meat of the children will never be given to dogs. But you can make up your mind to become one of God's children today by surrendering your life to him. It doesn't cost you anything. All it takes is for you to just come before the altar and then you surrender your life to Jesus. And today, as the Lord is leading me, because you are going to begin to live elevated life after doing this, you are going to come out and stand with me on the altar. And I will pray for you on the altar. You are here, you want to give your life to Jesus, quickly just come out. This has never happened before, but God is just doing something new in your own life. Just come and stand on the altar. Now the rest of us, let's lift up our hands to the Lord. Lift up your hands to him. Thank you. Thank you. There's somebody here, as I said, lift up your hands to the Lord. You are saying, oh my God, how will I lift this hand again? How will I lift this hand again? Lifting your hand has become a problem because of the pains that you've been having in that hand. If you're that person, just come out with that hand. Because as you are coming to the altar, before you go back to your seat, that pain will have gone. As the Lord liveth, just come out with that your hand. Come out with that your hand. The rest of us, lift up your hands unto the Lord. Those that are coming out to surrender their lives to Jesus, don't stand at the foot of the altar. Come up on 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 the altar. Now you are going to pray to God and say, Father, I can't hear you. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I stand under your authority and I speak to the womb of the year 2011 that every blessing meant for me in it, before the womb closes up, let it be released for me in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray to God. Prayers, and then take the offering and the benediction. You want to pray to the Lord that the miracles that God have lined up for this week, that God should make you a beneficiary of them. Believe me honestly, this time next week, several people will stand here to give their testimonies. And I'm praying for you that you will be amongst those that will testify. So you will pray to him and say, Father, I can't hear you. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, qualify me by your grace. Qualify me by your grace to be a beneficiary of the miracles you have lined up in this breakthrough week. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray.